calling. There's a chair that waits for you, and a friend to understand everything you're going through.
Hey, everybody.
What's up, everyone? Day two of our midweek evangelism.
For this week,
we are headed to Mangere. Even with the school holidays, the traffic is always pretty hectic, so we headed out early. But pray for us, as a lot of the times we will have technical difficulties with technology and
like
all that. enemy comes and try to steal, kill, and destroy. But pray that we have a one heart and the word for today. Amen. You know, sometimes I prepare the word. When we do Ōtara, we circle around. When we do Mangere, we circle around, and we're believing for that prayer. The prayer of Jabez, as God is going to get ready to enlarge our territory. Hallelujah. Amen. For his kingdom. It's not for us. And we're just humble servants. You know, listen, I'm not the most gifted, not the most talented, not the most of anything, but I recognize very early that I have a gift and I cannot hide it. When I think of the love of God in my life and how he saved me out of all the despair, all the brokenness, I cannot sit still. I cannot sit at home and Netflix and chill. I cannot sit still in a, you know, in the cubes. I've got to keep moving.
I just wanted to share a word that God has put on my spirit since just in the season, you know. It's a scripture that many of us know very well, and that obedience is greater than a sacrifice. And to do what we are doing for the Lord has come at a great cost for our individual lives, but through it all, there is greater reward through the obedience and what God has called us to do. And in the season where God has called us back out into the streets, we have already seen the hand of God, the reward in our lives, personally, but also in the ministry as well. When we minister, we fellowship, we meet people on these streets, and it just reminds us day by day why God has called us out and why we need to remain obedient, why we need to stand at the post that God has called us. Because if we don't stand there, then who is gonna stand at that place? We each have an assignment, a God-given assignment, that just like the canary that Pastor Kalani was sharing about before, that every canary, God has embedded into them a song. And it's the same with us human beings who have been created in the image of God, that he has embedded in each of us a call, a specific calling for our lives. We weren't just created because to exist. We were actually created for a purpose. And God has a specific plan for each of our lives. And when you know your purpose, you know what God has created to do, and you live in that, there is no greater fulfillment. There is no greater satisfaction in your life and staying true to the will of God. And this is why obedience is always greater than whatever sacrifice, whatever you had to walk away from, whatever you had to give up, whatever you had to surrender. Obedience is so much greater than all of that. And we're reminded when we went out last night, we met those kids on the street, when we were with the, you know, with the lady as well, that the woman that I met last night, it's just a reminder why God has called us to be obedient in this.
A long time ago, my pastor in Logan, Pastor Manuia, highlighted to me something, how, you know, a lot of people are going out to the nations, and God's doing something where God is bringing the nations to us, and we've got to appreciate that something that is actually happening right now in lifetime, not just in Australia, but here in New Zealand. We took in about over 100,000 immigrants from other outside countries, and some of those countries never heard of Jesus. And so God is bringing a mission field to us. Sometimes we've got to appreciate that God is doing something even here. You know, not just for inside the four walls, but outside, you know. And as I've driven around in South Auckland, I've seen so many different nationalities, so many different people all over the world coming to these places for work, for study, for things like that. And so, we got to utilize that opportunity to share the gospel to those people who might go back to their nations and spread the gospel. Hallelujah. So I just wanted to share that as well. You know, God is good and God is doing something. God is doing something new. Amen.
Are you Lord God Almighty? Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. You are holy. Come on, join it. Holy. Are you Lord God?
Are you Lord God?
Almighty.
Almighty.
We cry, worthy is the Lamb.
Worthy is the Lamb.
Worthy is the Lamb.
Worthy is the Lamb.
You are holy. You got a better one than that. Say holy.
Testimonies on our outreaches, and yesterday at Ōtara, I told a few testimonies of people coming to the Lord, and I think I might do the same tonight. I'll share a few testimonies. Testimonies is good, and I, hallelujah. One testimony I wanted to share was about 10 years ago.
Well, Judy was just asking me, there was a lot of people going past waving, and they were doing their mana waves, so I'm going to show you my mana wave. My mana wave is pretty unique. I think I got it from my old man. So there's that, but what I do is I do a bit of a run up. So it's like a run up like you're an Australian cricketer, bowler, Shane Warne, like those ones. But then you reverse it and then you're going to bring it up like you're going to bowl, like a bowling alley. And then down here, and then bang, like that.
Wow, that's so interesting, because...
But when you do, you gotta kick your leg back, like, bang, like
wow.
That.
That's so bang, interesting, because I've lived in New Zealand longer than you, and I never knew that.
Oh, it's just...
I was just like, they're just doing this one, wave,
that's
like...
wave at our
arms, like, so that
was
awesome.
So,
go show us the full...
The full view.
Yeah, full view.
So run up, like...
That looked, wow, very interesting. About to trip over.
It came from your peers. So much negativity. Hallelujah. Love you, Mom and Dad. God bless
Hi.
You. Love you.
Oh, it's...
God bless you.
It's Eden too.
Love you guys. Oh. Stay safe out there on the road. And it's sometimes so... those words that can be spoken over you can become a reality. Hallelujah. I myself can testify to this. So many times you can be told you're useless, you're not worthy, and you start to believe these things.
Hallelujah. It's Thursday night street ministry here in Mangere Town Centre. Praise the Lord for the gift to be able to minister His word. We've just seen a few of our family and our loved ones drive past here, and a few others also showing love and support for us. You know, it's not an easy thing coming out here to do street ministry, not an easy thing to come out, break out of the mold, to break out of the church wars, to break out of what is orthodox, but we do it because of our obedience to God, and also because of the soul that God desires for us to save. And I always say to my husband that there is always a soul waiting on the other side of your yes. So when you say yes to Jesus, there's no turning back. That is why we do what we do. Many people ask, why do we go out to the street ministry? Why do we bother sitting up? Why do we come out when it's cold and it's wet? And it's because of our love for God and His love for people. That it says in the word that God desires for all to be saved and to come into the knowledge of the truth of His word. And that is why we come out here, because we know God desires for many to be saved. But if no one is going out into the streets, then how will the streets know who Jesus is? If No one is going out to minister the word of God out beyond the church walls, out beyond the buildings, out of our homes. And how will the people in the streets know who God is? And that is why we do what we do. That our heart of this ministry, of First Love Jesus Ministries, is that we are sent by the one, for the one. We're not about millions. We would preach the gospel to the one as we would to if there was 100 or 1,000 or 1 million, no matter how many or how less there is. If there is the one that God has sent us for, that is the one who our heart is to minister the gospel of salvation to. So we just pray that that you will be blessed in this journey as we take you along with us. A whole part of our lives, of who we are, is Jesus and ministry. So be encouraged and be empowered that if God has called you out, to be obedient to what he has called you to do.
Who need it? Hallelujah. Prayer to protect yourself from fear. In Psalms 27:1, it says, "The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid?" A prayer to mend a broken heart. In Psalms 34:17-18, it says, "The righteous cry out, and the Lord hears them. He delivers them from all their troubles. The Lord is close to the brokenhearted and saves those who are crushed in spirit." A prayer to ask for mercy. In Psalms 51:1-2, it says, "Have mercy on me, O God, according to your unfailing love, according to your great compassion. Blot out all my transgressions, wash away all my iniquities, and cleanse me from my sin." And a prayer to ask for God's protection. In Psalm 61:2-3, it says, "From the ends of the earth I call to you. I call as my heart grows faint. Lead me to the rock that is higher than I, for you have been my refuge." I thought I made my wow on the guitar, but you know I'm a nitty. So my little man up in me and yellow, and you know. We prayed that yesterday that God will hold off the rain. I think we'll be right. We've got about another hour. The Columbus clouds over here. You see the pattern of the... But God is good, man. You know, it's just about taking you close. We'll walk over here a bit. See the trees here. See the trees. You see the wind on that flag? That's a southwesterly. Southwesterly. It's going to go westerly and come back south.
Sure, sure.
Yeah, you see those? Crystal-like kind of happiness. The temperature's about maybe at 23, 24 degrees Celsius, not Fahrenheit.
And your wind?
Oh, I already told you, it's going southwesterly. So once it gets south, my feel go southwest. But yeah, this is the weather, Mangere. It is school holidays. We usually get a lot of young people.
I know, up here.
So that's how I try to come. But listen, it's not about the crowds, man.
There's somebody listening who's in their car. There's quite a few cars.
I can share so many testimonies.
There's quite a few cars parked up too.
Oh, something that we went out and we did, and then it came back later. We didn't even know it.
Do your mana wave.
Huh?
Your mana wave.
My mana wave. Ready? Say. Hey, I gotta kick this leg.
Got that on camera. We just had another mana wave from over there. They saw Pastor K doing his mana wave.
The mana. The wairua. In Australia, we probably would have got shut down already. But the freedom here in New Zealand,
no permits,
beautiful.
The police wave at us.
With a few VV. Had led him to the prayer of salvation. They had led him to the Lord. And that was the sign that God had given him. And since then, he's been serving. And that was probably 8-9 years ago now. But I just like sharing testimonies like that, because sometimes we can get like that in life, where we would commit to God or give our lives to the Lord. And sometimes our walk with the Lord isn't always perfect. And the biggest lie that the devil can tell us to keep us away from God is, no, you're not good enough. Remember, you tried to go and do that. You remember you went to try to do the church. You remember you grew up in the church, but you started drinking, you started smoking, you started partying. Nah, that's not your life, bro. And these are the lies that the enemy tells us to keep us away. But thank God for this young man. He had that conversation with God. And God, when we seek, we will find. You know, the Bible teaches us when we draw close to him, he will draw close unto us. And so there are a lot of lies, like I preached earlier in my first message, there are a lot of lies that are spoken over us that we need to cancel out. We need to delete that language out of, and we need to teach ourselves this, the word of God, the truth of God's love. And so many of us live in those lies. They live, I'm not worth it, I'm not worthy, the rain is coming, amen. But we're going to keep preaching, hallelujah. A little rain didn't hurt nobody. But we continue to pray that God is still at work in you. When you don't see it working, God is still at work. When you feel like, I remember once one of my brothers came to me and he said to me, man, I feel so far from God. And I remember a scripture that our parents used to always say, that raise your child in the ways of the world and you will not depart from it. I remember that. That to raise your child in the word and he will not depart from it. And I sensed that there were many of us that were raised in the church and we ourselves physically depart from that. We go and choose something that is outside of God's will, that is outside of what we were supposed to do. But may I encourage you today that you may feel you're far from God. You may feel you have departed from the word, but the word has never left you. The word of God, God's hand over your life has never left you. I know for me, 20 years ago as a troubled youth, I thought I was, why would God come and show himself to me in a prison cell? Why would he come and give me a second chance? I threw out all my chances in the world. I did all the wrong things. It's my fault I'm here. Why would God come in? And I had that conversation where God revealed, yeah, I'm the one that's to blame for all this misfortune that I've had. And I had a case, cases. As we're not here to Bible bash nobody. We're not here to preach at anybody. But I'm just here to extend this open invitation that's always been here. This open door that's always been there. Jesus has been at the door of your heart, knocking at the door of your heart, and he's calling people home. That's why there's places you go that you just feel out of place, misplaced. There's always, you know, there's only so much drinking and drugs and gambling and all that. For he so loved the earth, the world, that he gave his only begotten son, that you will not perish but have an everlasting.
Hey everyone, the lighting in here is not the best at the moment, but I've just come in the car because as you can see outside, it's actually started raining quite heavily. I just wanted to take this time to honor Pastor Kay, who is right out there. He's still proclaiming the gospel like it's not cold, like it's not windy, like it's not wet, like it's not getting dark. This man from when we lived in Brisbane City, and we were he was ministering the gospel in the heart of the valley, one of the darkest places in Brisbane City. From there to here, nothing ever stopped this man from proclaiming the gospel. He is truly living out the heart of this ministry, which has been sent by the one for the one. And I wanted to honor him in this moment, his surrender. Wanted to honor him for his obedience to the Lord, but also his love for the Lord, to do the Lord's work regardless. Like, nothing stops this man from doing God's work. So I wanted to take this time to actually honor him. He stood out there proclaiming, preaching the gospel. A prime example of someone whose heart is fully surrendered to the Lord to do the work of the Lord. And he's encouraging everyone just to keep worshiping God. He is truly living out the heart of this ministry, which has been sent by the one for the one.
and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For it is with your heart that you believe and with and are justified, and it is with your mouth that you profess your faith and are saved.
Your lives, Lord, I just ask, Lord, that you would go before them, that you would provide for them whatever needs they have, God. You know it all. And I thank you, Lord, that you would provide in great abundance. I thank you, God, that you would provide in a way that they would know that it's you, God, that they would have a personal encounter with you, God. And so I thank you, Father, for your perfect plans, for your provision. I thank you that you go before them, that you protect them and their families, and that you will keep them safe. And I thank you, God, that your favor is opening doors for them right
yes,
now,
Lord,
that nobody else can close. I thank you for your grace that is sufficient. I thank you for your love that will make a way for them where there seems to be no way. And wherever they are to go from this night, from here, that, Lord, your Holy Spirit would go before them. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And amen.
Yeah, that was so good. Oh.